Also tonight, a Marion County jury found former Indianapolis Colts linebacker Josh McNary not guilty of rape.
Now, a woman claimed that McNary assaulted her in his apartment last year. Here's Eyewitness News reporter Rich Van Wyk, who's downtown live tonight with a look at the verdict, which came in late this afternoon. Rich.
Andrea, I spoke with one juror. He told me there just wasn't enough evidence in the state's case to overcome the reasonable doubts of jurors' doubts to Josh McNary's guilt. For more than half a year, Josh McNary faced the possibility of living for years in prison. Now he's just looking forward to living.
It was a difficult position for me to be in, for my entire family to be in, friends, loved ones. But, you know, I'm happy that I'm still free. I'm still able to pursue, you know, my dreams and, you know, all the things that were on hold.
The jury took little more than 2 hours to reach their verdict. Stanley Edwards was one of only two male jurors. Although they discussed the evidence against McNary and deliberated each count separately, Edwards says from the very beginning, no one believed he was guilty.
Well, I believe them two and God is really who knows what happened. What we just didn't know because there wasn't enough evidence.
In their closing arguments, McNary's attorneys pointed jurors to inconsistencies in the woman's statements to police and her testimony. Edwards says they were a factor.
When she said it supposedly happened, she had two different stories with what happened afterwards. So to me, it was just too inconsistent.
The two met at a downtown bar. When it closed, they went to McNary's apartment and had sex. He claimed it was consensual. The woman said she begged him to stop, tried to leave, and tried to fight him off, putting deep and bloody scratches in his back. Medical experts testifying for the state and the defense disagreed on whether her injuries were the result of consensual or forced sex. McNary's parents hugged in the hallway afterward.
You know, I wish it hadn't come to this, but, you know, today has been the best out of, you know, really bad circumstance. So it's been traumatic, tragic, but I've pulled, you know, a lot of good things away from it. So, you know, there has been some silver lining.
He didn't elaborate on that silver lining, but Josh McNary says he hopes to resume his professional football career. The deputy prosecutors trying this case left out a private secure door to the courtrooms. Late this afternoon, Marion County Prosecutor Terry Curry issued a statement. Here is what he says of the verdict. From Prosecutor Curry, we are confident the jurors have conscientiously considered the facts and circumstances in this matter, and thus we accept and acknowledge their verdict. Again, that from Prosecutor Terry Curry. I am told the victim or the alleged victim in this attack was in the courtroom at the time, but there were no noticeable outbursts of emotions when those verdicts were read. Andrea?